Hey guys, it's Kevin again, and in this video, I thought I would review to you Chaplin, the musical soundtrack. Even though it's not nominated for Best Musical, I thought I'd do it for you because Rob Mcclure is nominated for Best Actor. So really, I'm going to talk mostly about Rob Mcclure here, but I am going to get into the soundtrack. Overall, it's a pretty mediocre soundtrack. Like, there are some songs that are really good, and then there are some songs that really suck. And not, like, bad suck, but there are some that are just kind of silly. I will tell you the strongest songs, because I'm not going to go through every single song here. But I think the strongest songs are If I Left London, Life Can Be Like the Movies, Just Another Day in Hollywood, which in my opinion is the best song, and All Falls Down. I'm sure the rest are great, but those four are the standouts for me. And also What You Gonna Do, although All Falls Down is pretty much What You Gonna Do, just done better. But the thing I want to talk about, of course, is Rob Mcclure in this soundtrack. He is fantastic as Charlie Chaplin because I saw him in an interview. You wouldn't even think he's Charlie Chaplin. He looks nothing like him. But when he's on stage, he looks so much like Charlie Chaplin. I mean, look at that. I don't know if you guys can see it, but look at him right here. He looks a lot like Charlie Chaplin. So yeah, he looks a lot like Charlie Chaplin, and he actually, this was a show back in 2006, I believe it was, like, performed in, like, local, theaters that weren't really popular, but it didn't come to Broadway till last year. And I always thought that since I've listened to the soundtrack, I thought, Rob Mcclure really deserves a, you know, he really deserves a Emmy for this. I mean, not Emmy, but a Tony for this. You know, he really deserves a Tony. And I thought about that. And now that I've listened to the other soundtracks, it's like impossible that he's going to win the Tony. Because at first I was like, he's a swinging for the Tony. But then I thought, you know what? His performance was not that good. And it still is very good. And the first time I listened to the soundtrack, I thought that's the soundtrack of the year. The soundtrack of 2012... was Bonnie and Clyde, or was between Bonnie and Clyde and Newsies. Those were the two for me. But this really is a mediocre soundtrack. I mean, as I said, the best ones are the ones I mentioned. There are some other really fun songs, but there are a lot of really fun songs and not a lot of really, there are a lot of short songs on here that are quite short. I mean, there's a love story, but you really don't care about the love story because the problem with the soundtrack is the same problem everyone says with the musical. They speed up everything, and it goes too quickly, that once they get a story started up in Act 2, you're just tired and you don't want to see it anymore. But the other person I want to acknowledge here is Jen Colella as Hedda Hopper. Holy crap. Holy crap. Holy crap. Why was this girl not nominated for Best Supporting Actress? She's freaking amazing in All Falls Down. I mean, listen to her. Again, the country is embraced. But I'm a voice among the crowd that's questioning your cause. And now I'll spread my doubts among the rest. And what you're gonna do? She's amazing in this song, and I have no idea why she wasn't nominated. Because Rob Mcclure was nominated. She should be nominated for Best Supporting Actress, because she's freaking amazing. The problem is that this is in the second act. Hedda Hopper is nowhere in the first act. She's in the second act. And the problem is that they can't get a story going because the first act is so different from the second act. And you feel that on the soundtrack. Like, the beginning of the soundtrack, it's very fun, but then they get this whole big story going, and it gets very deep, and you kind of just don't like it anymore. And after All Falls Down, it kind of just sinks from there, and it really isn't good anymore after All Falls Down. I think All Falls Down was the last song that I absolutely loved on this soundtrack. I mean, all the songs in Act 1 are great, but then Act 2, once they start up this story, it gets very dramatic, and it just feels like a different show. Because the first act is so comedic, and then the second act is so dramatic. It doesn't really make a lot of sense. And you probably are like, what the hell is this kid talking about? I know what I'm talking about, because pretty much you just gotta go listen to the soundtrack, okay? That's my advice to you. If you don't believe me with this, go listen to the soundtrack, because I know what I'm talking about here. I've listened to the soundtrack. I'm not trying to sound mean or anything. I'm just saying, you're probably thinking, what does this have to do with the whole review of the soundtrack? I'm trying to tell you why I think that Rob Mcclure is not going to win Best Actor. I know for a fact he's not going to. Because Chaplin is so overlooked by everyone. And before, I thought, why wasn't Chaplin nominated for Best Musical? I know why. Because it's way too, I think, scattered. Like, everything is scattered in the first act, and then they get a story going in the second act. But it's just very scattered in the first act. Like, this happened, and this happened, and this happened, and this happened. He had this movie, and this movie, and this movie, and this movie. And Just Another Day in Hollywood is the best song on here. And that is because it is very fun. It really sums up Rob Mcclure's, Rob Mcclure's talent, the Charlie Chaplin's life. And that's why I love Just Another Day in Hollywood so much, because it sums up Charlie Chaplin's life perfectly. It has a very fun song. It has a great chorus. Like, the chorus in this musical is amazing. The three songs, What You're Gonna Do, Just Another Day in Hollywood, and Life Can Be Like the Movies. All three of those songs are amazing because of the chorus. Like, the ensemble is perfect. There's nothing wrong with the ensemble. The problem is with the story. It just isn't a very good story. It is a good story, but it's not done well. And that's why it closed so fast, because everything was rushed, and it wasn't really good enough, I think. That's why it closed. Because I believe it came on in, like, I think it was, it ran for a long time, though. I mean, it came on in, like, it was either July or August, and then it left in January. So it did run for a very long time. So, I mean, it's not like it's overlooked. I think it's overlooked because it came in August, and it came in, like, July or August, and they're trying to, at the Tonys, they do recent musicals, like, the ones that came out, like, Bring It On had come out back in September, Christmas Story, like, it was either October, November, and probably, I think it was September, actually, for a Christmas Story, Kinky Boots was this month, and, actually, Kinky Boots was last month. Matilda was last month. So, you know, they really try to acknowledge those type of musicals. And Chaplin definitely is overlooked, but it should be, because it's not good enough to be in the best musical category. I do feel like Rob Mcclure, though, should definitely be nominated. It really shows in If I Left London. I'll say this. This show has some really strong songs, and it has some songs that are not very strong. But I think, again, Rob Mcclure and Jenna Colella are both fantastic on this. Like, they're both really great in all their songs. They're great. The problem is that some of the songs are just kind of rushed and they're too short, or it's a matter of you don't really care because the musical gets too deep. Like, there's this song called The Exile, and you hear, what you gonna do, and you got this weird music like, da 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 da. Da, 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 and you hear, what you gonna do when it all falls down? And it's very weird because that music really does not go with that song, and it's not really, I mean, that song's awesome. But that song shows up too much in the musical. So that's pretty much my review of Chaplin. And again, I thought it was gonna win Best Musical, but I really just did it to show you, because Rob Mcclure is nominated, so I thought I would go over it. And again, it's not going to win Best Musical because of everything I said, and I just don't think it, I mean, Rob Mcclure is not going to win Best Actor because of what I said. He was not nominated for Best Musical also because of what I said. And if you don't believe me, just listen to the soundtrack. You'll see what I'm talking about, because you'll say, this is really random. You'll go to the second act and you'll say, this is very different. It is. I mean, I was like, I remember when I listened to the soundtrack, I'm like, okay, this is a little bit different. You'll notice the first act, the songs are really fun. Second act, the songs are kind of dramatic and too deep. But that's it for my review of the Chaplin the Musical soundtrack. Hope you enjoy it, and I'll see you guys next video. By the way, there are a swarm of Broadway soundtracks coming in this week and next week. It's crazy. And it's because of the Tonys. Like, yesterday, was crazy. Because, you know, Annie came out. Pippin's up for pre-order. You know, these shows that aren't coming on into, Pippin's not coming out to July in stores. Till July. Scandalous came out today. Hands on a Hard Body is coming out Saturday, I believe. So, yeah. So I'm going to try to list all of them, but I'm going to try to... I'm probably going to stay away from Scandalous and Hands on a Hard Body, because I know for sure Hands on a Hard Body is nominated for one thing, and it's not going to get it, because it's just nominated for Best Original Score. So I'm not going to listen to Hands on a Hard Body. I really don't want to, because I heard it wasn't very good. And Scandalous, I don't know, I might, but I most likely will, because the girl who's in it is nominated for Best Actress, but I will definitely listen to Annie and Pippin. You can guarantee I will listen to those two. Oh, and The Mystery of Edwin Drood, so you can guarantee I will listen to those three. So I will see you guys in the next video. Okay, bye!